Imagine you just developed a Python web application. It works beautifully on your computer. That's why you developed it. Your app requires a bunch of things to run flawlessly. A Python interpreter, maybe a framework like Django, some libraries, and you need specific versions of all these dependencies. So you need a very customized environment for your application to run reliably. Next, you have to run this application on hundreds of servers in your data center. Also, your team members start pulling the code into their computers so they can work on it too. All these computers will have very different environments. Some may be running Linux, Mac, or Windows. They may have an Intel processor or AMD. They might be running different versions of Python and the dependencies than what your app actually needs. They might also be running other applications, but you want to ensure that your app gets the right amount of CPU and memory so it can function properly. As you can imagine, ensuring that your application gets the exact configuration of resources and dependencies on every computer it runs on is a very hard problem. You will run into conflicts. But what if you could take your app and all its dependencies and put them inside a nice clean package? Now, whenever you want to run your application, you simply download this package. It already comes packed with all the supporting goodies that your app needs to run successfully. This is how containers were born. A container is a technology in Linux that isolates one or more processes from the rest of the system. The containerized process can run with its own set of dependencies without any interference from the outside world. So if app A needs Python 3.2 to run and app B needs Python 3.9 to run, installing them both on the server itself could cause conflicts. But if both these apps exist inside their own containers, they could be running with their own Python versions, their own dependencies, their own libraries, their own custom environment, and there are still no conflicts on the host machine. How cool is that? Docker is a platform that lets you develop, distribute, and run applications as containers. These containers contain everything your app needs to run. Code, libraries, dependencies, a total suitable environment. And ultimately, Docker is a piece of software. You might run it on your laptop, servers, data centers, Raspberry Pi, maybe even a satellite, I don't know. You can use a command line application to package your application into a container image. This image can be distributed to any other computer in the world. If that computer runs Docker, your container can be run on it in no time. Since containers are a Linux technology, Docker was originally written for Linux. There are some Linux process isolation features such as namespaces and control groups that make containers possible. But now you can also run Docker in Mac and Windows. Do you know why? Even in these operating systems, Docker is actually running a Linux virtual machine behind the curtains. The containers are still ultimately running inside Linux. I know, right? Only big companies with lots of resources, like Google, could use Linux containers in production. Docker made container technology much easier to work with, therefore increasing its adoption. Docker made containers mainstream. This is what led to its exploding popularity. Here are the top four benefits of Docker. You can run your application consistently regardless of the underlying platform. It's a lot easier to redistribute your app to different systems because everything is inside one clean package. Your app is isolated from all other processes, so none of them can interfere with its operations. You can specify the amount of CPU, memory, storage, and other resources your app needs, and Docker ensures that it gets them. No more noisy neighbor problems. You might be wondering, a container sounds a lot like a virtual machine. They both isolate our workloads and provide resource boundaries. So what's the difference? I want you to share your opinion in the comments. In the next lesson, I'm going to answer exactly this question. What's the difference between a container and a virtual machine? If this is your first time here, my entire channel is dedicated to making you a world-class DevOps engineer. Make sure to subscribe so I can help you too. See you in the next video.